Okay friends, anyway, you already completed all your 15 weeks, you done your exam and all that. As a final note, let us recap what we have done in the entire course so far. We began with state space search, we looked at how the problems, some of the problems which cannot be solved using conventional methods can be converted to state space representation. And we've looked at different types of ways you can represent your problem using state space. We studied that there is a start space, there is an end space, and basically we need to start from start space, start state, and reach to the goal state. And we looked at missionary cannibal problem, far chicken grain problem, those milk jug and water jug problems in that module, in that particular week. The second week we started talking about two different types of search, is unguided search and the guided search. Unguided searches, we looked at breadth first and depth first and some of the other variants of it. The guided search, we began with hill climbing, and we've seen few variants of hill climbing in that particular week. We've also seen some of the complexities involved. For example, local minima or local maxima is an issue with hill climbing, and that's, we tried to address that thing later, but that was one thing that we did in the second week. The third week, we looked at some of the issues related to the search process. We looked at local and global heuristic functions, we looked at frame problem, we looked at assisting search which help you in assisting, and we also looked at something called genetic algorithms, which mimics how nature evolves, picking up best things out of these species and making sure best survives, and when best mate they beget offspring which is better, and so on and so forth. The same thing is applied here. We begin with some random solution and improve over the period of time, making sure that at the end of the process it gets the best solution out of it, or at least a solution with required constraints satisfied. Okay, so in the fourth week we began talking about neural networks. We looked at how brain represents knowledge, we looked at the brain neuron, we also seen how researchers mimicked a brain neuron into an artificial neuron and how they look like, and then we have looked at activation functions, square function and sigmoid function, and then backpropagation neural network algorithm, how it changes its weights, how the activation flows in the forward direction, how the errors propagate back. We discussed about all that. In the next week we looked at a lot of other search algorithms. We started with end colony optimization, then branch and bound refinement search, A star, AO star, agent based, and so on. So that was the second week, and I remember why we did that, because multiple solutions, multiple problems required different approaches in solving them. So when you have plethora of this search methods, probably one of the search methods fit better for a given case. Okay, so that was the reason why we talked about those search algorithms in that fifth week. The sixth week we looked at very important, very critical part of AI called planning. We talked about forward and backward reasoning, we looked at progression and regression, we looked at relevance of that regression. We introduced Bloch's world problem, which is very suited actually for this kind of planning. If you want to really plan, for example, a robot wants to plan something, he is given a job of sticking things and unsticking things, he has to do something. Then how will robot do it? Like robot have to plan that. Okay, so that kind of a solution can be generated using these methods. In that we looked at goal stack planning. We also looked at the problems with goal stack planning, especially that Sussman's anomaly. And then we looked at plan space planning, which eliminates some of the problems that goal stack planning had, but is comparative, a pretty complex way of doing it.